better of her little outburst in Shortland Street.
Sentencing tomorrow, early plea of guilt will be taken into consideration. Matt, they've mentioned your name here as the link between Hugo and this place.
Lucky me. What are you going to do when Hugo goes to trial and all those nasty little skeletons come tumbling out of the closet? Not going to make you look too flash now, is it?
They shouldn't have mentioned your name. It's upset you. I can see it.
No, it hasn't. I'm fine.
As far as I'm concerned, your department is yours to run as you see fit. And by all accounts, you're doing everything right.
I'm going to push my ideas for change, Judy, whether you like it or not.
What are you really after, Maya? My job?
Yes. I want your job. And I'm going to get it.
But that is such good news.
What about Andrew?
He's been in contact with Hui and it's all sorted now.
Oh, that is so good. Oh, I didn't want to believe that of Andrew. What an awful time you have had. Maya, Hamish is staying. It is so wonderful and it's just so, so good. Oh, for goodness sake, Maya, what is up with you? Duh.
We should celebrate. Let me buy you a drink.
Oh, no way. I'm buying. Definitely.
Judy, I'm sorry. I said things that I shouldn't have.
No.
I just don't understand.
I've heard enough from you, Maya. You don't respect me. The people who matter do, so you've obviously only got one choice.
I should resign.
What else?
I don't want to.
Well, why stay working with someone who doesn't share your high opinion of yourself? Who thinks your ambition exceeds your ability and experience?
I just wish you would listen to me instead
of... Oh, spare me another hissy fit. And get real. You're a long, long way from getting my job, but you're so very close to losing the one you've got. Go home, Maya.
Hi, just staying, just checking in. No news on medical, Paul, you would have called me. I know I'm pestering you, but I need to know soon as. Talk soon, I hope. Bye. Hi.
Hey. Jay's closing up. It's good to get out of there. All everyone's doing is talking about Hugo.
Well, he'll get his tomorrow.
Yeah. Hey, you never liked him, eh? But you still asked him for that money for me.
You're wishing I hadn't.
No, I'm stoked I'm here, but I'm wishing I hadn't let him move in. I pressured you into it and you had this gut feeling about him.
That he was a creep, not some psycho.
Yeah.
Hey, got a message from the fertility clinic. They've got some times for counselling appointments, so shall we call, see if they suit?
They suit?
You maybe.
Oh, hey, all the extra work you do for Chris, surely he'll let you
Yeah, he'll be all right with that. How's Jay? Not sulking too much that she can't have a baby Henson? You have told her that she's been struck off, that she can't get her mitts.
She knows.
Not good enough. Next week, when we go to the clinic, my name goes on the list, Jay's goes off. Okay?
Yeah, sure.
We're going to make a baby.
Mm. Well, there's always the old-fashioned way.
Check it out.
No way.
What?
It's twisted.
Thanks.
I'm feeling stink enough already without feeling sick.
Cheyenne rattling your chain?
No.
Etty. What's he done now?
Gone off with Mel.
Not Mel the mole.
Her Royal Highness.
Oh, he'll be a busy boy then.
Why do guys always go for the skanks?
Because we can.
That is so lame.
It's the way it is.
Skanks suck.
Who's this guy?
It's his new girlfriend.
I thought you were just going through a rough patch.
Oh no, the love affair of the century has ended. She dumped him.
Oh, Scarlett.
Yeah, Jimmy told Cheyenne that Izzy's off with Molly Mel now.
Molly Mel?
Have you seen them together?
No, I've seen proof. Hickey's.
Well,
big tragic. I'm such a player. Hickey's on his neck.
That doesn't sound like you, see.
Well, it's definitely Molly Mal. How could he?
How much do you care? Talk to Etty.
Want to go and get a load of his hickeys?
Well, apart from the hickeys, you're only going on what Cheyenne said that someone else said. Talk to Etty and see what he has to say for himself.
Escaping, huh?
Sorry?
Hugo's still the hot topic out there.
Yeah, but I'm actually catching up on paperwork.
Hey, Mum said Hugo's lawyer wanted to talk to you.
Yeah, no biggie.
So you're okay?
Yep, I've gotten over myself.
Yeah?
Yeah. And I'll stop beating myself up, talk about pathetic.
Babe, it wasn't pathetic. It was real. Makes me love you all the more.
Boys.
Hui is not wrinkly.
Well, doesn't she know you can't get back with Etty now?
Why not?
Well, unless you want to do what Mel the Mole does.
Why would I have to?
Why would he go back to the salad burger once he's had the upsize combo with fries?
I'm not a burger.
Well, she's frying his right now.
Look, we don't even know for sure that Etty's even been with her.
Begins with H and ends with Icky.
I'm still calling him.
You can't. He's secondhand goods.
Oh, same as Noah then.
Hello.
Hi.
Scarlett.
Could you come round at 2:00?
Sure.
Beck's giving you grief.
Oh, no, she wants me to go around there later.
She's probably going to beat you up. Heard about you and Mel or something.
There is no me and Mel.
Yeah, but Scarlett doesn't know that.
You guys just made it up.
Yeah, and now everyone's talking about your hickeys.
Hey?
Mel and her motor mouth chomping on your neck. It's the talk of the town, mate.
No way these are hickeys. Bro, you were there.
Yeah, you sure Mel's vacuum lips didn't do it to you later?
Bro, shut up.
Oh, moly mouse. Shut up, man.
No wonder Scarlett's snobbing me.
Hi. Tanya said you'd be hiding in here.
I'm actually catching up on paperwork.
Sorry. Big day today. I wasn't going to go, but then I thought I would.
You're talking about Hugo's sentencing?
You coming?
No. Why would I? Why are you? To see justice done?
No.
For closure. How nice for you.
There's a bit of that. Why don't you tell me why you're staying away?
Pass.